Hi, I'm Shirley Wong. You may know me as Little Miss Bento. So I make cute designs using food. I'm going to share with you a really fun and simple recipe inspired by Miffy, and we're going to make it into a cute lunchbox. Today, we're going to do something quite simple. So we're going to do a Japanese egg. We're also going to do a sauteed vegetables. And I have some prawns at the side. So once the pan is hot, we're going to start adding a little bit of garlic on both sides. Going to add in the Japanese egg. Just a thin layer, yep. So we're going to fry the garlic until the fragrance comes out. And also you can look at the color, so it should be nice and kind of lightly brown as well. Okay, then we're going to add in a little bit of carrots on one side. So if you like, you can have mushrooms as well. So the egg is done. Just one layer for now. Just be gentle when we take it out. Okay, then we're going to fry our prawns. Then don't forget about our egg. We still have to do our egg, so give it a nice stir. So for the prawns today, I'm going to season a little bit with Japanese sake, maybe a little bit of salt. So while we wait for the prawn to cook, I'm going to start rolling our eggs. We'll let the egg cook for a while. And for the vegetables, we're going to add some dashi powder. They're usually made from fish as well as seaweed. So we're going to take the prawns out. Let's check on our egg. So give it a nice flip. Press it down, helps us to shape the egg. The egg is done. Now that we're done with the cooking, let's make the bento. We're going to start by making Miffy, and I'm going to show you how to do it. So first up, we're going to shape the rice ball. We place the rice inside the cling wrap, so please get a heat resistance cling wrap. And then we're going to shape it into the shapes that you want for your character. So in this case, we're making Miffy today. So we're going to make a nice round ball like that. We're going to make the ears next. We're going to squeeze, kind of basically make like an oblong shape. Just roughly want them to be more or less the same size. So we're going to make a small body now. So this portion, you will need about half a cup of rice cooked. So the feet, we're going to just flatten it slightly. So this is the hands, just going to quickly divide them into two so I get both sides. So I'm going to basically trim this into the dress for Miffy. So I'm going to show you how to do it. I'm just going to get any of the round cutters to mark the circle. And from the circle, I'm just going to cut out. So wrap it around on top of where I want it to be. Take the cling wrap, and we're going to flip it on the other side. And basically wrap it. Use some tape for the sleeve. And you wrap this around the hands that you made just now. Again on the other side. Then with the same concept, we're going to use the cling wrap and kind of wrap them together. To cut the eyes, using a small sharp scissors. As you cut, you turn the seaweed, rotate it so that you can cut a circle. Don't worry about the shape at this point in time. You can cut it slightly bigger. We're going to cut strips for the mouth. So basically thin strips, about 1 mm. So we're done with Miffy. So this is Japanese fish cake, what we call hampan. So we're just going to trim out flowers. We're going to cut four. So we're going to use the circle and cut the center out. Okay. So once we have cut out the center circle, I've actually prepared some round circles before we start frying the carrots. What you're going to do is you're going to just gently press the center in. Okay, we're going to do that for the rest. We're going to skewer the edamame beans with a bento stick. So now that it's done, we're going to pack the lunchbox. So I'm going to fill up the box with the side dishes that we prepared earlier, which is the salted vegetables as well as our prawns. It is easier to pack the box when the box is not too empty, so that the character's design will not keep moving around as you're making the little fine details. Now that this is in, so we have about half a box that is kind of empty. We're going to start by adding the body first. We're going to add in the heat. So take out the rice from the cling wrap. Then we're going to fill in the sides here. And now we're going to add in the rest of Miffy's details, which is the ears, the hands and the feet. So I'm going to start by adding the feet. And then the hands are going to go in. Then we're going to add the ears for Miffy. But before we do that, I'm going to add in some of the decorations that we did just now, which is my edamame bean, and then we're going to add in the flowers. We're going to add in the eyes and the mouth that we cut just now using sushi seaweed. And finally, we're going to add the ears for Miffy to make sure that they stick together and don't fall off during the transportation of the bento box. We're going to use deep fried pasta sticks as an attachment. You can also use pasta sticks that are baked. And it's done! Miffy Bento!